Hi again, Facebook fans. It's Chuck Leyenberger. Joining me here, it's Julian Barnes. He's our science supervisor here for Roanoke County Public Schools. And Julian, while we got a little bit of a cloudy day going on today, we're hopeful and keeping our fingers crossed for a bright, sunny day on August the 21st. Why do we want a lot of sun on August the 21st?
Well, because if we see the big sun, then we can see it being covered up by the moon.
That's right. So we have a big solar eclipse coming up on the 21st, a couple days before school starts. But hey, science never stops and learning never stops. It's a great opportunity. But we want to make sure that folks can do this safely, because first and foremost, looking at the sun, pretty bad idea, isn't it?
Horribly bad idea. Yeah, it intensifies the light and it just ruins the backside of the eye.
And
the crazy thing is that there's been a number of times when people have experienced and they look and they think they got by with it, and the next day they wake up and then they can't see right in the middle of their eye. They can see the edges, but they can't read signs. They can't read.
And they burn their fovea out.
Yeah, and it becomes a big problem.
And there have been people who have gone blind.
Absolutely.
Staring at the sun. So
those that have recovered, it took them almost a year consistently to build that back up.
Yeah, so
don't do that.
So kids, moms, dads, absolutely do not look at the sun, with an exception.
Well, and again, we're never looking directly at the sun. So the trick to it is how do we get the image of the sun in a manner that we can see it without looking at it.
Right.
And so that would
And
be
so we got a couple of different ways that are plenty you can make at home to be able to see the eclipse without necessarily looking directly at the eclipse. And this is all talking about something called pinhole cameras.
Yep. So the idea behind a pinhole camera is you take a teeny tiny little pinhole, literally a pinhole.
Yep. We've got some examples right here.
Yeah.
So we put
a little piece of, well, let's cut on this side. We've got a little opening in the paper, and then put a piece of aluminum foil on it. And so we put aluminum foil so we get a really sharp little hole. You don't want a raggy hole, you want a sharp little hole. And we just punch through ever so lightly, like so. And we've got a pretty nice little hole. It's not perfectly cylindrical because I jiggled a little bit. But anyway, you want a perfectly little tiny little hole. And then you'll position that against either another piece of paper. You get a better image if you do that. Let's say if the sun was in that direction, we want to position it so the sunlight's coming right through our pinhole, and then the image comes through the pinhole and puts the image there. So the way to keep from looking at it, I found, if you'll keep your back to the sun, so you see your shadow, and this over your shoulder, let the sunlight peel in through that little hole and kind of position it. You'll kind of have to play with it and get it in focus. And the further out you go, the bigger that image on the paper becomes.
But you'll see the sun there.
Absolutely.
And then as this eclipse starts, and it's going to take place in the afternoon, again, hoping we're having some nice clear skies, you'll literally see that curve.
Just start eating away at it. So you'll see the whole thing. And if you, sometimes people will have like a straw hat. You know, the straw hat, you can get little flecks where the straw lays over. And if you hold a straw hat, you'll see multiple images down upon the ground. But one's just really nice so you can see focus and see the whole thing going on. The other option, yeah,
so
we could get a box. You could do the same thing with a box. And sometimes that's handy because it gets this extra light out of the way. Again, the same thing. We poke a little hole, and then we just focus it. Again, you want to keep that sun to your back, and you're looking at the image, and you get it.
Turn this way so folks here can see.
Good. Yeah, let's say I've got it over my back, and so the sunlight's coming right through my little tin.
And it's just going to come right down through.
Come right through that. And so
you can
show it about like that.
Do that way, or even kind of do it this way, or anything like that.
Yeah, you could actually even build it. Again, if you could put a couple of boxes together and actually put your head in it, and the only thing that would be in it would be, you don't want to be driving like this, but you could poke it over your head and have the image coming through over your shoulder.
Just make sure you don't get your head in the way of the image.
That's exactly right. And again, the longer it is, the longer the distance between this pinhole and this image, the larger it'll be.
So you can get a nice, really big circle if you can get a couple of boxes.
Yeah, get a refrigerator. Go get a refrigerator box, and then you got a nice,
like
nice image.
You can have something really, really nice. And these are very simple things that you can make at home. Literally, we just had some sheets of paper here and just a couple of little squares of just normal aluminum foil.
Yeah. Now, if you do,
maybe a little bit better, but normal aluminum foil.
Sometimes you can find these. These are actually solar viewing glasses. And they're cheaply made. They look like 3D glasses, but they're not 3D glasses. Mm-hmm. They are very heavy covering, and so they're safe to do a solar eclipse on. But do be careful, because there's a lot of folks out there selling these things. They're not very expensive in the first place, but there are people who are selling knockoffs that aren't protecting at all.
Yeah, that aren't safe. You want to make sure that you're looking and making sure that they say that they're ISO certified, that it says, like here, it says meets the 2012 transmission for that for filters. So you want to make sure they're safe, that they're the right type.
Yeah.
And so, you know, these are available. We've seen some on Amazon, a couple other places, although, frankly, you got to hurry, because a lot of them are selling out fast.
That's exactly right. There's an article on National Public Radio on August the 1st that they were interviewing a gentleman. He was talking about they actually manufacture them in Ohio, and they've already sold like 800,000 pair, and they're looking to shoot for a million, is what they're shooting for.
So let's talk a little bit about the eclipse. So here, for folks who are watching in Roanoke, while we're going to see a really good eclipse, it's not quite the whole
perfect
thing.
That's correct. And this one's really neat, because it's the first one in like 38 years that we've seen this much, and it's completely in America. It's called America's Eclipse, because it's actually from coast to coast, the first time we've done that in a number of years. So the path, if you think about the sun being this enormous ball, and it's about 400 times larger than the moon. But it's 400 times further away than the moon is. So visually, they're really close to the same size. So when you think about the moon, the moon can slide and almost completely cover it. But all those things have to be in perfect alignment to get what we call a total.
Right.
And so we're not exactly in that pathway. If we were in South Carolina, it'd be right in the middle of the pathway. If we were in Cheyenne, Wyoming, right in the middle of the pathway. But we're a little out of the edge, so we won't get 100%.
Yeah, we'll get somewhere in the neighborhood, depending on what part of Virginia you're in. Roanoke area looking like about 90%. If you're a little further southwest, especially towards NRV, it might be 92-94%. Into North Carolina, maybe even 96-98%.
It'll be impressive.
You know, it's still going to be very impressive. You're going to pretty much see just a little sliver in its totality. And it's only the totality or closeness thereof is going to be very quick. It's only like 3 minutes or so, and then
it's just moving on to the next.
Right on by.
That's exactly
so,
right.
So, guys, we want you to have a very safe viewing of the eclipse. We hope you will take the time on the afternoon of the 21st to come out and see this eclipse. This is, for some, a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to see something this
big. The other thing I'll mention, too, Chuck, there's some interactivity if you're interested. NASA has a site up and a free app that you can record the temperature, because the temperature drops down.
Yes, it will be.
When the sun's clouded over, or not clouded over, but blocked over by the moon, that temperature will actually drop down. So NASA's looking for all that data and plug it into the whole national scene, and I think that'll be a fascinating
piece
of
data.
Yeah,
so you can even help.
So you can participate in that.
Right, you can help record part of history, thinking that some of the meteorologist friends of mine have said, you know, temperature drops anywhere from 10 to about 15 degrees.
Yeah, it's pretty significant.
So, yeah, you'll definitely notice it.
3 minutes, so it's not that big a deal. But
not that long, but, you know.
But still has significance. And so it'd be real interesting to see it as it charts across the U.S., that temperature and how much temperature difference.
Yeah, and space.gov and NASA.gov are going to have a lot of opportunities if, hopefully not, but if we happen to have a day like today where it's a little bit cloudy and you're not going to directly see the eclipse, obviously we'll know when it's happening because it's going to get darker. You can go online to space.gov, NASA.gov, and I'm sure they will have up live cameras from areas with totality that you can come watch it online. But really, if you got the chance, and it's a sunny day, you have to come out here, see it in person. But we definitely want you to do so safely. So, Julian, thanks for being
Absolutely.
With us, folks. Again, we hope you get a chance to enjoy the 2017 solar eclipse and to do so safely.
Absolutely.